Here come the Derby Council 15 following the All Blacks out onto the pitch. There at the in the centre of the pitch, you can see Dawn Palethorpe on Sir Gerald, one of the fastest wingers we must have seen in England this season. On the left-hand side of the picture, the Lord Mayor has been running such wonderful possession for Derby Council in the lines out. And it's the All Blacks to kick off, Wilson to kick off. Oh, and I can see there the chairman of the Byways and Highways Committee, who's obviously recovered from that very nasty blow he got in that loose ball in the first half. And Wilson kicks off, and it's the Town Tucks taking the ball beautifully there. The All Blacks are up on it very fast, and the whistle's gone. I'm not quite sure what happened there. I couldn't see, but there's a scrum down. I think it's an All Blacks ball. Well, they were up on them very fast. Obviously, they're going to try very hard in this half to wipe out this five-point deficit. Derby Council, 8 points and three up, and Derby Council have got the ball against the head. There is the Barrow Surveyor, the scrum half. He's out of the chairway of the chairman of the Highway and Byway Committee, who's kicked for touch. The line out, and it's into the line out, and the Mayor has got the ball again to the Barrow Surveyor. He's left out the medical officer of health, straight along the line to the Lady Mayoress, and the Lady Mayoress is going to go through. Number two is Mister, who's taking up the fullback, who's only the fullback to beat, and she has scored. The Lady Mayoress has scored. It's 11 points to three.
Cliff, this must have been a very disappointing result for the All Blacks.
Well, they've had very bad luck on the tour so far. In fact, they missed four very easy kicks against the Exeter Amateur Operatic Society, which must have cost them the match. And then, of course, there was that crippling defeat at the hands of the Derry and Tom Soft Toy Department. So I don't think they can really be fancying their chances against the London Poovs on Saturday.
And what about China?
Well, whether Mao Zedong is alive or not, Lin Piao has a stranglehold on the Central Committee, which Lin Shaoqi can't break. So it remains to be seen whether Chu Enlai can really get his finger out and get going in the second half.
Well, thank you, Cliff. Tonight's other outstanding match was the semi-final between the Bournemouth gynecologists and the Watford Long John Silver impersonators. We bring you edited highlights of the match. About it for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. But remember, if you've enjoyed watching the show just half as much as we've enjoyed doing it, then we've enjoyed it twice as much as you.